For a long time, the diaspora have been investing in essentially personal projects, you know. But the idea now is to get the diaspora to participate in mainstream national development agenda. And this includes particularly the big four.
When you look at the latest Central Bank of Kenya statistics, in 2017, Kenyans in diaspora remitted back home close to 197 billion Kenya shillings. In 2018, they remitted close to 214 billion Kenya shillings. And this is a clear indication that Kenyans in diaspora have a clear role to play in Kenya's development as a foreign direct investment, and the government is really taking cognizance of their presence.
Did you know that mobile money can save you up to 50% compared to global money transfer operators? Did you know that mobile money has the advantage of being able to pay utility bills, school fees, and other expenses easily? As a Kenyan living in diaspora, your options for either remittance information or best value for money are many. A number of tools, websites, and mobile apps have been developed to help you make the best choice in terms of sending money home. Take time and have a look at the detailed ebook called Send Money and Invest in Kenya, a guide for diaspora remittances and investments. This document has been developed to assist Kenyans in diaspora make a wise investment and financial decisions. What channels can you use to send money? Who are the key players in the financial sector? A good understanding of the remittance market will save you time and money.
We have the housing finance, for example. Actually, it's not only just housing finance, but also several banks have a diaspora package that they are now offering to people who don't bank within the country.
As a Kenyan in diaspora, you have two main options for sending money. The first option is through money transfer operators. MTO such as Western Union, MoneyGram, WorldRemit, or SimbaPay. MTOs are non-deposit taking service providers who transfer money on your behalf. Secondly, we have remittance service providers, RSPs, who can be money transfer operators, mobile network operators, or banks sending money directly to recipients or through agents. What should you consider before committing yourself to a service by an RSP? The Diaspora Remittance Guide explains all the important considerations guided by international good practices. Anytime you want to send money to Kenya, consider the following. How fast is it? Is the price fair? Is my personal information protected? Is the channel secure? How will the RSP disburse the funds?
There's a reason why Kenya is number one in terms of mobile commerce. This is because the Central Bank of Kenya made it quite easy. A lot of policies, the government has had quite a lot of interest in areas related to mobile money. Right now, if you are in, for example, you are in Europe or you are in the US, you are able to transact money back home, not just to Western Union, that used to be the case, but you can send directly to the person who is supposed to receive the money. You are also able to bank, to send money to your local bank in Kenya through mobile money. And the Central Bank has also made it quite easy for Kenyans in diaspora who are paying taxes in their countries of residence. In case they want to send money back to Kenya, they also get a tax amnesty, and this is something which I would like to encourage the government to keep on facilitating.
When sending money to Kenya from abroad, you have a number of remittance service providers that you can use, including MoneyGram, PowerPay, SendWave, Western Union, WorldRemit, Equity Direct, SimbaPay, Azimo, among others. Within East Africa, registered M-Pesa users can send money to Tanzania, Uganda, and Rwanda using Safaricom International Money Transfer Services.
One of the best products that you have across the world, it is the M-Pesa that is well known, not only in Africa, in Kenya, in Africa, but across the world, where people are still looking at how successful it is and how the government, how the Kenyan were able to really do that and then to be able to have such a good product.
With such a wide variety of RSPs to choose from, it can be difficult to compare services and identify one which is the best for you. That is why the Diaspora Guide gives you information on available price comparison tools. Top on that list is IOM's MIG app, which compares remittance service providers serving the Kenyan market. You can also check out Remittance Prices Worldwide, which is a website run by the World Bank with information on remittances from Rwanda, Canada, South Africa, Tanzania, the UK, and the US. The African Institute for Remittances also maintains a regional price comparison tool called Send Money Africa, which is certified by the World Bank. Send Money Africa provides price comparison information on a number of channels in the continent. Other comparison tools you can use include Monito, formerly TawiPay, Monetis, and FX Compared.